one.
Yeah, of course. From Australia, Captain Blush. Start to quick. Start to babble quick, eh?
Hello, all RC... We were talking in Sweden so long now. Hello to all viewers and subscribers. Welcome to our channel, where we edit nothing because...
We don't know how.
We don't know how.
No. I mean, we don't know how, but we have decided from the moment one that this channel will not edit nothing, so you can really see how this beautiful hobby looks like. And now, Captain Milan, start to salute, so you don't forget. You must salute someone.
First, I will salute Mei Lin from Australia, and I will salute Aussie RC Flyers.
Great.
The next one is... You said something a few seconds ago.
That we will film separately. You can talk now about this box, Captain Blush. Huh. Because I think that you wanted this box for such a long time. Well, and now you must tell the story. How did you came to this box?
This story began, I don't know, maybe a few years ago, 2 years ago, when I was flying PT-17.
I can show, eh?
The bisexual plane.
Eh. Huh?
The bisexual plane from Kyosho. And I said that I always wanted to get PT-19.
I remember that because you were talking about that even to the Kevin Unger from the USA. Salute Kevin quick. Because
and he... I will salute also...
The boys from the hill, eh?
The boys from the hill. And I will salute Night Flyer Dave Herbert from Ohio. Because actually his video inspired me of this PT-19.
And you must say thanks to him. I forgot. I mean... It is way back, but he has sent it as the postcard I have told you for the Christmas. So, hey.
I salute you, Dave. And, of course, your video of your PT-19, which you had, if I remember all right, ASP FS-61 mounted on the plane, but unfortunately you have lost it in the fire. So, ever since I have seen that video, I wanted one of these planes, but it is just impossible here to get. And then one guy, Jeremy Burton,
salute quick,
contacted me and he was asking me which size of this would I like. And I said, of course, the giant scale.
You have the knife there, you know that.
Yes, and then...
That's what you said to me.
And then, after a few days, he contacted me back and he said that actually his father has at home a brand new inbox, PT-19 giant scale from Seagull, that he would like to send me, and his name is Larry.
Salute him twice.
Yes.
Once and once again, like this, because,
yes.
Hey, who would send you a giant scale, your dream plane, all the way from the USA to Slovenia? I mean, this is amazing, okay?
And, what's this?
What's that?
Oh, look at this.
What is it? Oh, warbirds.com. What's this?
I don't know.
Ah, very cool. Yeah, these are this is the manufacturer of this plane.
But this is Seagull, not Vehicle.
Yeah, Seagull, but they're all made in the Vietnam, don't you
SG.
See
SG!
Yeah, but Seagull and the Vehicle and even the Pichler, Captain Blush, all these brands are made under the Vehicle.
This is, you have this, Seagull Lysander.
Yeah.
I have now this and I also have
You have the Tiger Moth, because the Tiger
Decathlon,
Moth from Hobby King. The Tiger Moth from Hobby King is in fact from Vehicle Models. They make really good planes, Captain Blush, eh?
Now
read.
I will read.
Read quick.
Dear Blush, I'm sending you this aircraft because my son, he talked to you online. He told me this plane I'm sending to you that you are having a hard time of finding anywhere. My name is Larry Burton. I'm from Kokomo, Indiana, in the USA.
Salute him quick twice. Yes. Once more.
And I will salute again.
The finger.
I have been doing models for over 55 years. I enjoy RC planes. I like the gas planes, yeah, just like me. I've been looking for a primary 100 RC plane. Yeah, that one that I got, but unfortunately you cannot get it anywhere.
Yeah, that is gone, eh?
I'm not having any luck finding it. Yes, me also. I have tried your son told me that you would want like one, but...
Is that store even open anymore? The store has closed, isn't it?
No, the store is still open.
Ah, it is?
Where I bought it, but that was the last one. I would like to ask if you can measure the fuselage and the tail and the length of the rib. Oh, okay, I will measure the plane and I will send the measurements to your son. Just, I will try to scratch build. And I would like to thank you for training on the four-stroke engines. Yeah, of course, I like four-stroke. And when I find out that you will be sending me this plane, I've already...
You have the engine for that thing.
Already acquired. But this is...
But look at the size, say.
This is 120, 20cc. And actually, I have worked on this engine last year for a friend from Croatia. I have changed the back plate, the carb, the intake manifold. I have changed the bearings. So all the engine is almost as new. And then, on some strange coincidence, this engine came back to my workshop. From Croatia.
Yeah, and that was a destiny.
Yes.
It was a destiny that this engine came back and now you have the plane for that engine.
Yeah, salute Boki.
Salute him quick and start to open because, hey.
Yeah, you have
to. I want to see this, hey.
Oh, what's this? Oh. What's this? Oh, for the phone.
What's for the phone?
This. You put this back on the back of the phone so it don't
drop it.
Doesn't your daughter have this?
Yeah, I think so, eh.
Oh, you put this onto your car.
Yeah.
And you just pop it in.
Yeah, pop it in, yeah. But it's interesting, yeah, that the...
Look at the sticker.
Oh.
This will go on my transmitter box.
The Veko Warbirds, I have told you, Captain Blush.
Wait, what's this, eh? Something else inside.
What, all this came with the plane or what?
No, these are the presents. Oh, look at this.
Yeah, but these are all Veko.
Look at this.
Yeah, but these are all Veko. Maybe Veko models puts this in the boxes or what?
No, I think this is the present.
These are the presents, but where did he get this?
I don't know.
This is so sexy. Look at this flag, eh?
Yes. Huh? What does it say?
Yeah, Veko models, what?
Keep them flying.
Hey. It looks pretty sexy to me, huh? To put it on the wall.
Thank you.
Yeah, but this bird will be something, eh? I think that you will use the servos from my plane, from that Marchetti, and you can just assemble this one, eh?
I have servos at home.
You have servos for this? I have a few. But, or I will just order them, because you must assemble this Captain Blush soon.
Yes.
Don't just talk.
Oh, what?
Sweet talk.
Look at this.
Oh.
Look at this and be impressed.
Hey. I know this looks sexy. Wait. Specification.
Uh-huh.
First I can show this. Hey, but look at the landing gear.
Well, according to this, that it came.
I mean, we never had a problem. I mean, the Seagull planes are really good. Well, but now you can see that these are the Veko planes, in fact. And now I can show you specifications.
Yeah, show me also.
So you don't have to talk later.
2.2 meter rings. Look at this. 91 to 120, four stroke, and I have
this,
just that.
Here we go like Star,
this guy
Star
was
Wars,
using.
Like a Star Wars, look at this.
Yes. This guy was using, I can see by the color of the.
And finally we have a green plane. Now I will use this. Don't ruin this because I will use this for the time.
You know what? The robot is a good thing.
What?
This has fixed landing gear.
For once you will not have to worry about ruining the landing gear on the runway. But
maybe I will even get.
But
I know for, do you know what I know for? I know for a slightly bigger engine. Say it on 150.
Yeah, but do you need bigger engine?
Maybe I don't, but who knows?
Yeah, for the weight. Mm.
Oh.
Look at this, eh?
Look at this,
Put it there slowly. Don't ruin it. You will have it for the closure of the video.
No.
Hey, look at this, eh?
This is the...
With the manual still inside.
Look at this, eh?
Some commercial, of
course. You know this plane?
No, I'm looking at the Stuka. Look at this, hey?
Yes, this is yours.
Wingspan?
2.3, this is yours.
This is it?
Yeah, yes, and this is also it.
Yeah, I have the yak for Seagull.
Yes.
Also, that Stuka is for Seagull, I didn't even know that, eh?
Yeah, he told you.
Yeah, but I have forgotten. But viewers, you don't know. But the viewers don't know that, in fact, last year I have bought this plane. I have it in my hangar, Once in the array.
And you have
with 20 cc
RCGF gasoline engine
on it.
This.
Waiting. I mean, hey, salute quick for the manual because this is it, eh?
And just as you look at the back, you have, look, the travels.
Oh, show. Maybe someone will lose this and you can pause it here and you know it.
Well, the manual is, as it should be, very straightforward. Very easy. Oh, I can see some hinges, heavy duty. Okay, the next.
But hey, I mean, do you know what's the beautiful stuff? Because this is the 2 meter wingspan, Captain Bloch. I mean, this is giant scale.
Of course, yeah, it even says on the box.
Everything under, above 1.7 meter, 1.88. This is the giant scale.
Oh, look at this, splat flips.
Hey, but look at the size of this and look how sexy it looks, eh?
Look at this. No excuses. Hey, but this box came from the United States by the normal post, and look, it's perfect inside, eh?
And it has the splat flips, eh? Not just ordinary flaps.
Yes.
The splat flips.
Hinges already.
Look how shiny it is, eh? Look, like a piano.
You have to glue the hinges, like always?
Yeah, of course. Always check that, viewers, maybe you didn't assemble a balsa plane before. Usually you have just one side of the hinges already glued. The second one you have to glue it, eh?
Yes.
Remember how it was packed?
I will remember.
But I think that this plane, because it's yours, it won't take long for you to assemble it. I mean, I know that if it was mine, it would take a year, but now it's yours, eh?
Hey.
You will assemble it quick, eh? Hey, you were assembling the machete from my birthday last year, eh?
Yeah, but you can't fly, still, so
and the machete is still in the box, eh?
Look at this, eh?
Look at this.
I think this is for the landing, look at this.
Look.
Already pre-cut, look at this for the landing gear,
For the landing gear?
Look.
I can see, yeah. Oh, the landing gear is so forward? Yeah, I think so, yeah. I can see it in the picture, pretty forward, eh?
Oh,
so it won't tip
size.
On the nose.
Look at the size.
Hey. Oh, look at the color of the rudder, hey. Like this. Look at this sexy color, huh? Now you will see this plane in the air. Can you imagine how beautiful it will be?
Actually,
I think that you have now another plane that you will take on some meetings, huh, Captain Bloch? Because this, huh?
I think I'll have to buy a bigger car, eh?
Yeah.
To go on the meetings.
Look at this section.
Look at this.
Hey.
I can already see this on the runway.
Hey, I can't wait, Captain Bloch, for this maiden flight. But really, right now, at this point, eh?
This will be something.
Oh, look at this, eh?
The elevator?
The big aluminum bar.
You have to be careful not to cut anything.
But I can't believe that it came all the way from the USA and without any damage, I mean.
Well, I was afraid because there is actually a big dent.
Yeah, well it is. Yeah, here, I can see here. It here.
But luckily it is nothing, hey.
Well, sometimes, say, I mean, hey.
And
from time to time, we can be lucky.
Actually, this plane went to the customs, and I was afraid that they would want to know the price for the plane, and then I would have to pay a high customs. But actually, I paid only $5.
Well, that was nothing, eh?
Yes. Look!
But hey, for this kind of plane that you can't get here, eh, even if you have to pay a lot more, it will
course.
Be worth it because
of
you have course. You have your dream plane, Captain Bloch. This is like the Messerschmitt 262 for me.
Yes.
For Captain Bloch is this plane.
Look at this. It even says you cannot do it wrong.
Oh.
I had never seen this before. See? Top.
Top. Yeah.
Look at this, how this fits. Look at this.
But do you know what I love? Because this is under the brand of Seagull. It is with the real, this is real Aura Cover foil or what?
Yes, of course.
Yeah. I'm reading there. Yeah, of course it is. Because on the Veko models that we had by now, do you know that Warbirds, there was self-adhesive foil on.
Yeah.
Sticker foil. I mean, it's pretty good, but it can get wrinkled. But this is something, eh?
Look at this. Oh, aluminum? Hey, there's some...
What?
There's some tubing inside for extra strength.
Look at this.
And?
This is the first time I see this.
Look at this, eh?
What's that?
An antenna, do you see?
The antenna, where does it have it? Oh, of course, here in the back, look at this, yeah.
Just like a real one, eh?
Yeah, but this is some, yeah.
These are the push rods. Already there is silicone tubing on for the safety. All you need for ailerons, flaps.
Hey, I think that you will enjoy this assembly, huh, Captain Block? Tell me.
I will.
Oh, look at this stuff, eh?
Should I open them?
Oh, look how big it is.
Of course, it's a big plane.
Well, I didn't imagine that the pilots is so big. Take one out, it's
okay,
good.
I'll take one.
Look at the size of this.
This is the front one, this is the back one. They have even the earphones, so they can talk to each other.
I can't wait to see this.
There's a lot of stuff inside, I think.
You have the windscreen.
I will not open this. Here is the fuel tank, the pitot tube. What is this?
For the Saito, do you see this?
30 cc DLE if you put on are these holes. If you put 1.6 cubic inch are the round holes.
This is the first time that I see this. Do you see this? Salute them quick. For different engines, I mean viewers, look at this.
I will use 1.2 cubic inches.
No, so you just check that size of the dot.
This is the stars.
Yeah, the stars. But this is amazing. And then you can see where are the holes for this.
If I will put 130 cc on this, maybe I will put Saito 150.
Yeah, but where do you have that Saito?
Stane has one.
30 cc?
Golden Knight.
Won't be too big?
Yeah. You can put 30 cc.
Yeah, dale. Yeah, no, that is the gas engine.
But is this heavier than the 150?
Heavier?
Yeah, of course.
Maybe it would be good, huh?
Look at this. Hinge, control, these are the hinges for the flaps.
Look at this, eh?
Wheels, look at the size of it.
I can see the nylon bolts.
Everything.
For the wings.
Engine mount.
This will be easy to disassemble.
Oh, wheel
look
caps.
At the coverage for the wheels, eh?
Yeah, just like on the...
on the Piper.
Tiger Mod.
Hey.
These are the windshields. I will not take them out.
No. We can see them.
This is... What is this? For the coverages for the wheels, for the supports. And the back. This.
But this is one amazing plane.
What is this? Instrument panels.
Looks like real one.
Yes. The landing gear, look at this.
With the suspension.
Of course. And heavy duty ones, eh? Single models.
I mean, the planes with the retractable landing gear are so beautiful, but you're just afraid that you will break them every time you go fly. Every time you're wondering what will happen on the runway. But if you have the fixed landing gear, who cares?
Who cares, eh? Look at this. Look at this.
Look how beautiful, look how shiny it is, eh?
Look at this.
Look at the size of this. This will be so beautiful plane that this will hurt.
I think that I will have to get that Saito, eh?
You will have to?
Or maybe even NGH 30 cc gasoline, 4-stroke.
Yeah, I know for one, eh? I know for one! For how much he will sell it? Did he say?
170.
170?
That is less than half of the price.
Well, if you have got the plane for free, Captain Blush, then maybe you can risk the money for the engine, eh? Or maybe you will wait and I will buy that engine and I will give it to you, eh?
I think I will wait. I will wait a few days.
You will wait a few days, not much. Because I know that you know that I will buy that engine when I will see this plane starting to be assembled, eh? I'm just crazy enough.
And that engine is actually almost new.
Will that fit?
Well, if it, the DLE 30 would fit. And it's...
But that one is how much?
The same size.
Uh-huh.
If it fits 30 cc DLE, then it also fit 30 cc NGH. No problem whatsoever.
But maybe it would be the best that you will have one...
Gasoline
sexy, cheap fueling plane. Huh?
Look at this.
Look at the size of this. Look how it's pulling it out, Captain Blush. Huh? look at the size.
Look at
and
this.
And it's look so this. Sexy because it's low wing.
Look at this and be impressed, eh? Look at the
inside, how it's made. Look, it's tough as a rock, eh?
Is it?
Yes.
Stiff as a stiffer's mother. Look at this.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. Axis hatch. So you can also, you can have the wings attached, and you can.
Oh.
Look at this.
Yeah, I think that this is the only axis hatch. Is there any other?
No, but.
No, this is the axis to the plane.
Because on my Orion, you cannot access.
Unless you take the wings off.
The wings off. And but this.
A salute Seagull this quick for this. Because they have thought about the pilots.
Orion is also the Seagull models.
That is Black Horse.
Black Horse, I'm sorry.
Orion is Black Horse, and they didn't think how will you get to the stuff and electronics without taking the wings off, but Seagull was thinking exactly about the Captain Blush this time.
And
we can see that this is really,
you know,
really
what?
Good done.
If I would put NGH on, I will not use this tank, but actually Mitya gave me the other day when we went to Potstoka a few of the original gas tanks.
We have the gas tanks, salute him quick,
Mitya,
with that Stuka. And do you see now how the things will get in the place exactly like they should be, Captain Blush? All this was meant to be on the, do you know on what day? On the day that we have filmed the first video.
Yes.
It all came back now to this, that you have got your dream plane, you have got the fuel tank for the petrol engine, and of course your,
now.
Oh, show this.
The marriage.
Yeah.
Hey. I think that this will, because actually there is not so big engine, it will fit in perfectly.
Wait, don't drop it. Be careful, Captain Blush. Because this will be a one of your most beautiful planes. Do you know that?
I think so, yes.
Huh? This will really be. Will you put it a little together, quick?
Yes, very quickly.
Or maybe, yeah, you can try to put the aluminum bar through that you will put later on. Just so we will maybe see just a little how the plane will look when it will be assembled. Eh?
Yes.
Just be gentle. Be gentle.
It was hard like the first time, eh?
Yeah, I think that this was the first time that the bar was in, eh?
Yes.
Look at this fit.
Look at this fit and be impressed. First one.
Just be careful as hell, Captain Blush.
Yes, of course.
Because you know how long you were dreaming about this, and now your dream came true. Hey, but look at the size of this.
Look at this fit.
And now grab it together, grab it together. Grab it with the wings so we can see it. I will go like this.
I'll grab this wing.
Yeah, grab that wing, and now you can see viewers really, look. Wait, I must go a little to the back, eh? It's so big. Now look at this plane, eh?
This is.
Eh, but it looks so beautiful. Huh?
I look. Think it will be.
Hey, Captain Blush, I think
on,
that you are now, eh?
If Mitya still has that engine, eh, I think it will be on here. Now look at this, I'll pull this on very quickly. Hey, look at this, look how it fits. Come here and film this, hey. Hey, it's not even a thousandth of an inch clearance, hey.
Put it out once more, because so we can see that in fact, look at this.
Look at this. Yeah. I think I'm having a climax here.
Hey, I think also, Captain Block. No, just leave it like that, eh?
Aha!
No. I'm without the words. And don't forget to disassemble this too quick. Because I must take at least one picture, Captain Blush.
Look at this, huh?
Yeah.
Cut it a bit. I will take.
And can you imagine with all the stickers?
Look at this.
Look at those happy pilots right at this moment, eh? They can't wait to get in the air.
Hey.
And I will take the picture like this for the thumbnail of
this
video.
You know
what?
If I have on my decathlon...
I will stand here because of the sun, eh?
If I have on my decathlon 26
boxer engine which weighs 1.5 kilograms and it's perfectly flying perfectly, well, that NGH is even lighter and the wingspan is the same. So I think that NGH 30cc will be perfect for this.
I'm just not having...
What?
Maybe like this.
What's wrong?
I know, the sun. I can see you in the fog or somewhere. Like
fog? I think that your hand is fogging the camera.
No. It's because of the sun through the wind.
Through the wind, yes. From the... But you can stand here.
Through the window.
The easiest way.
Or maybe like this, eh?
Like this?
But we must not see the calendars too much, eh?
No, it's okay.
Uh-huh, okay, like this.
As I said, I think that NGH 30cc will be perfect for this, huh? What do you think?
Yeah, I know that you're rooting for that one, because if I buy that one that you have there, ASP, will be for something else. You sneaky man, eh?
Yeah, but...
Hey, you are so good at calculations, Captain Blasch, eh? Hmm? Tell me.
If I wait... long
but hey,
even
hey.
This would be perfect, huh?
Well, I don't click much because of my crooked hand lately, so maybe... Yeah, but this one looks also great. Why not?
Yes, but...
What but? What but?
But gas 30cc?
Yeah.
Four stroke? Look at this. Maybe I will put this on. Because I think this would be enough for this size.
Yeah, of course it will be, Captain Blasch, eh?
Yeah.
Well, if they recommend this engine, I mean, we are wondering again, eh? You don't have to always put bigger engines on.
I didn't think about that engine until I saw that writing there.
Yeah, of course not. Maybe I will just take the writing away and you will not know about that anymore, eh?
So this is it,
Captain Blasch.
I will thank again Jeremy
and
Larry.
From the bottom of your heart,
yes,
because
thank you for this.
Who
this
would is, buy you something like
my,
this, eh?
This is my dream plane and I will assemble this with a lot of love, eh?
And you will fly it with the love and you will fly it many times because this will be your everyday beautiful sexy.
To disassemble, just take the wings off
and that's it. Maybe you will use, I will give you that connectors multiplex for the wings.
No,
or maybe you will not need.
I stole them from
you. You can steal them so I won't know and that's it. But maybe for this one you don't need it because in fact you have just the, you have the flaps. You have them. Yeah.
I will need them, yes.
Because yours you can buy the cables for the wings, for the balsa planes, that they have multiplex connectors.
So every time
they're so easy.
Assemble them, you don't have to think anything, just put them together and that's it.
Because that one will allow you with just one click together, you will connect the elevators, I mean the ailerons, the flaps, the wheels, everything that you have in the wing. With just one connection. I mean, you will show that when you will assemble the plane, what are we talking about right now? And now close the video somehow, eh?
Well, what to say?
Well, I think that you can recommend this plane to anybody
I can recommend if you can get them, because here actually it's very hard, but I know that the United States and some other countries, it's a lot easier to get it. And I think this day started very well, and today I think I would have made it with you know what.
You know, in a way, they are so blessed to live in America because you can get so much stuff there that we can't buy here in our small country.
And this is why. You think we have friends all over the world?
I was just trying to say that, but in effect, we are so lucky to have such a good friends that at the end, we can also have fun and joy with the planes like
all
this.
Hey.
It couldn't get much better than this, Captain Blasch.
Yes.
So this is it.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blasch signing off from Slovenia with the most sexy PT-19 which came all the way from the United States from two awesome guys.
Captain Blasch's dream plane is finally here.
Yes.
So I don't know, after this, I have got my dream plane, my Messerschmitt 262. You have got this dream plane. What, Captain Blasch? We filmed this maiden flight and then we will stop to film, eh? Why not? That's it. We have lived our dreams and that's it for the last 4 years. No.
There is a lot of more planes, eh?
Yeah,
that
well,
can be hey.
So this is it. Cut quick?
No, cut quick because...
It's Sunday and I still didn't have my coffee for today and I think that you have something to prepare for afternoon, eh?
I did prepare it yesterday night.
Yeah, but yesterday was nothing. No. We were just screwing on the runway.
Yesterday it was nothing because actually I will explain on the maiden flight.
Yeah, of course. On the maiden flight you will explain why yesterday was nothing.
Everything is over, but actually it was such a small detail that...
It was small detail, but there was no flying. But in fact, it's a good thing that nevertheless the plane is in one piece, because maybe that was lucky, eh?
That was a sign from the gods,
yeah.
Because...
Not to fly that yesterday, and you will fly today. So this is it, Captain Lush. Enough of babbling, because we just can't stop this video.
Yes.
We must stop somehow, and don't clean too quick, because I must take a picture, Captain Lush.
Okay.
So this is it, enough.